Since I'm here, I would like to introduce you to my garage sink.
He is beautifully nasty.
That looks like Popo.
Go do your thing.
I'm just gonna get right into it.
Oh, Lord. I'm just gonna let that sit for a minute, because damn. Bitch ain't smiling anymore. I'm gonna try some of that.
Guess what? We are done.
Let's refill together.
Ago, I visited Scrub Daddy's headquarters. They gave me a few boxes and told me, go nuts. I felt like a kid in a candy store. I grabbed everything and anything my little heart desired. But I also love to give, so I'm currently hosting a giveaway on my Instagram, giving away some of the most sold out products. Run!
Hey look, there is no hashtags, there is no caption too. So if you see this, then that means this post was meant for you. Thank you for not scrolling. I got one thing to say. You be you no matter what, no matter what people say.
A device that vacuums and washes my floor at the same time, I'm totally in. I love my Tinco, but cleaning it after each use is important. So let me show you how I do it. I take the bottom completely apart and make sure to wash everything. I then let it air dry completely.
Hold the water in, putting a little product in. You can add whatever product you'd like or no product at all. And then I'm filling it with hot water. Most people like the original mop because you can just fill it up and not have to use that little hole, but it wasn't a big deal. This holds 2.5 gallons just like the other one. I did go through a little bit more water than my other one. I think it is with the clean water, but it does hold the same amount. Look at this little gadget. My mop stands up. The other one didn't have this, so no more falling over mop. Okay, putting it in the clean water, putting it to the spin and giving it a good kick and spin, and I'm ready to mop. Now, this mop head is a little bit smaller, but the cords on the mop are a lot longer. So I didn't really notice a difference other than having to buy a new mop head. I didn't notice a difference performance-wise in it being small, but I did notice with those long cords on the mop that I can do the baseboards so easily. Now, I love using this for so many different things. The thing I did notice is when I spin it, it wobbles a lot, so I figured out just hold it with two hands, a little bit firm, and then it doesn't spin. You'll figure it out. It's just kind of like learn as you go. It did a great job mopping. Like I said, I have different heads for different uses because I use it on everything from baseboards to floors to cabinets, you name it. So a few little gripes or like critiques on this mop, but nothing about the performance, just about buying extras. But besides that, I'm really impressed. I love the spin mop system and I love how it keeps the water separate. It's a total game changer. So I would recommend 8 out of 10. Totally would buy again. Stoked. Gorgeous, baby. Like and follow for more. Boom!
So I did a mistake. I blinked my eyes and used the restroom at the same time. And and she found that one blue marker, the one blue marker that I forgot to put away.
Popped.
Damn. What is that?
A W.
Oh, a W. You were afraid that mommy would forget the way to her bedroom, so you had to draw her a line? A whole path? I like how she wrote the H and A right there. Because that little shit's laughing at me. I really hope this works. Look at this girl right here, sleeping on the job. You're fired. But I ain't gonna clean this up. You are gonna clean this up. First, you're gonna scrub that ha-ha off that floor. See who's laughing now. Okay, so this is working really great. You just gotta keep scrubbing. It's scrubbing the paint off too. This is where we're at right now, but we might have to repaint the wall.